Hello everyone, today we are going to see the beneficial and harmful effects of microorganism in immunology. In this term we are going to learn two points, one is normal flora and second one is our three lines of defense. First, what you know, what is normal flora? The microorganisms which are directly associated with the healthy tissue of any particular host, but which cannot cause or which does not cause any kind of disease are called as normal flora. Ashe microorganisms je healthy person madhe ki healthy human being cha tissue madhe present astat, but te kutla hi prakar cha disease cause karat nahi. Such microorganisms are known as normal flora, and these normal flora microorganisms can be present in different types of organs. For example, external organs like gastrointestinal tract, intestine, or kidney or urinary tract, etc. And some of the internal organs such as brain, heart, or even blood, they are generally present in sterile form. If ever in such internal organs if microorganisms are found, then it indicates the state of infection. Then we will see the beneficial effects of the normal flora microorganisms. First one is they prevent the attachment and penetration of pathogenic microorganisms. Now, any particular microorganisms which enters the body or causes infection, what they do? They first attach to the cell surface, then they penetrate, and then they cause the pathogenic effect. What the normal flora microorganisms do? They secrete some kind of slippery chemical. They can get a slippery chemical secrete karta, which prevents or stop the attachment of pathogenic bacteria. म्हणजे pathogenic bacteria काय करू शकत नाही, त्या slippery chemical मुळे cell surface ला attach होऊ शकत नाही. They can't attach the cell surface, they can't penetrate, and ultimately they cannot cause any kind of disease to the host. So first one is they prevent the attachment and penetration or the entry of pathogenic bacteria inside the host body. Second one is to compete with the pathogenic microorganisms. Now, normal flora microorganisms, what they do? They compete with the pathogenic bacteria or the foreign material which enters inside the body for the different purposes, for the nutrient or for the survival. जे पण body मध्ये nutrients develop होतात, हे microorganisms काय करतात? ते utilize करून घेतात, so that pathogenic microorganism ला proper amount of food मिळणार नाही, and ultimately they will die. Next one is they have the ability to produce antibiotics. Now antibiotics are produced to impede the growth of other microorganisms. Now the normal flora, in the normal flora the microorganisms which are present, they produce antibiotics to avoid or to stop the growth of other microorganisms. For example, E. coli, which is present inside the intestine, have the ability to produce colicin, and these colicin inhibits the growth of different types of pathogenic microorganisms. Colicin काय करतो? हा दुसरा microorganism जे disease cause करू शकतो त्यांची growth inhibit करू शकतो किंवा stop करू शकतो, त्यांना kill करू. Then they produce enzymes and vitamins. Now different types of enzymes like cellulase or galactosidase, etc. are produced by the microorganisms which are present in the normal flora, which helps in the proper digestion of the food material. Food material चं breakdown करो, तसं proper digestion power करो normal flora चे bacteria काय करतात, तसं breakdown करतो by secreting different types of enzymes. And they also have the ability to produce vitamins. Now E. coli have the ability to produce vitamin B12 and vitamin K, which are very important for the growth and regulation. So different types of vitamins can be produced by the microorganisms which are present in the normal flora, which helps in the proper growth and regulation of that human being or the host body. Next one is they helps in the metabolism. As we have stated that they have the ability to produce different types of enzymes, and these enzymes help in the proper metabolism process of the host. Next one, oxidation and hydrolysis of steroids. Now steroids are nothing but the artificially prepared hormones. And the hormones of the human being, or even the host's proper growth, प्रॉपर ग्रोथ रिजनरेशन अपने डिफरेंट टाइप के हार्मोन्स रिक्वायर्ड आता है जे हार्मोन्स है आर्टिफिशियली प्रिपेयर्ड हार्मोन्स ऑक्सीडेशन परफॉर्म करने हाइड्रोलिसिस परफॉर्म करने नॉर्मल फ्लोरा बैक्टीरिया खूब बेनिफिशियल दीज आर द बेनिफिशियल इफेक्ट्स ऑफ नॉर्मल फ्लोरा माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स. नाउ नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज हार्मफुल इफेक्ट्स ऑफ नॉर्मल फ्लोरा. द पैथोजेनिक बैक्टीरिया जर नॉर्मल फ्लोरा मध्ये जे बैक्टीरिया आहे जे आपल्याला बेनिफिशियल इफेक्ट कॉज करते इफ द इम्युनिटी ऑफ द होस्ट इज सप्रेस्ड त्याला एखादं इन्फेक्शन झालेलं असेल त्याची इम्युनिटी जर लोअर झाली असेल तर हेच नॉर्मल फ्लोराचे बॅक्टेरिया ऍज अ पॅथोजन म्हणून ऍक्ट करतात. मीन्स दे हॅव द ऍबिलिटी टू ऍक्ट ऍज अ पॅथोजन टू द होस्ट इफ दॅट इम्युनिटी इज लोअर ऑर सप्रेस्ड. अँड सेकंड पॉइंट इज दे कॅन ऍक्ट ऍज अ पॅथोजन ते पॅथोजन म्हणून ऍक्ट होऊ शकतात पण कधी इफ दॅट हॅबिटॅट इज चेंज ते जर नॉर्मल फ्लोरा मध्ये सपोज नॉर्मली एखादं बॅक्टेरिया किंवा नॉर्मल फ्लोराचा एखादा मायक्रो ऑर्गॅनिझम तो इंटेस्टाईन मध्ये प्रेझेंट असतो पण त्याचं लोकेशन चेंज झालं तो गॅस्ट्रोइंटेस्टाइनल ट्रॅक्ट मध्ये गेला तर तो तिथे जाऊन काय करू शकतो इन्फेक्शन कॉज करू शकतो. फॉर एक्झाम्पल इंटेस्टाईन मध्ये नॉर्मली इकोलाय प्रेझेंट असतो अँड दीज इकोलाय कॅन नॉट कॉज ऑर डज नॉट कॉज एनी पर्टिक्युलर इन्फेक्शन ऑर डिसीज इन द इंटेस्टाईन. बट when these E. coli is transferred or move to the urinary tract the intestine madhe ha kutla disease cause karat nahi pan intestine madhun jato urinary tract madhe gela tar in urinary tract it causes urinary tract infection je tachi normal jage peksha jar tachi location change zali body madhe tar tithe jaun to pathogen madhun act karun infection cause karu shakto. these are the harmful effect of the microorganisms which are present in the normal flora of the bacteria.